This is part three of the Genesys Integrated Board Flow Design series. The first two parts in the series covered the WhatIF frequency planning tool and Spectrasys system architecture tool. In this part, we will cover MFilter, filter synthesis, and MomentumGX 3D planar electromagnetic simulation. After we have completed our RF system architecture design in Spectrasys, the next step would be to design each of the blocks within the system, and with the Genesys integrated flow, we can do that directly within Genesys. As you can see here, we have our dual band Wi-Fi receiver. I'm going to use the mouse wheel and zoom in on our first RF filter and double click on it to open up the properties. As you can see, it's a 2300 to 2600 third order, and in the title you can see it's a Butterworth type filter. To design this, all we have to do is right click on the filter, go to Synthesize Subcircuit, and we get a choice of an active filter, a microwave, or a passive filter. Well, this is in the microwave filter band, so I'm going to click on that. And it opens up the microwave filter synthesis called MFilter. And as you can see, we can select the type, but it has been selected for us as a bandpass. The shape is Butterworth. And if I go to the Settings tab, you can see it is plugged in 2300 to 2600 and third order, the properties that were in our filter in the Spectrasys schematic. And if I go back to the Spectrasys schematic, and let's move these out of the way, and you can see if I open up our filter now, we have, this is the tab, the parameters tab we were on before. It says due to the override settings on the simulation tab, these parameters are ignored. And if we go to the simulation tab, you can see it's using our subnetwork bandpass filter that we just synthesized. So now, if we continue with our synthesis, I'm going to close our schematic and bring our filter design back. We can decide on, the MFilter has opened up a schematic window and a graph window, and we can decide on what type we want to use. We've already entered a Butterworth, although we could change that to a Chebyshev or Bessel or other shapes. As you can see, there's a number of subtype. There's end coupled, and as I click on each one, you can see the schematic changes. And we also have a comb line, which is a type of filter that's very small because it uses discrete capacitors in as loading to our resonant lines. I'm going to stay with the comb line filter. And if we go to the Options tab, you can see we have a button that says Select Manufacturing Process. It originally synthesizes using ideal components, which have impedance and the length of the lines in degrees. But you can change that to a standard physical design, such as microstrip, if just by clicking on one of the different 13 different processes that are available. I'm going to make the conversion frequency 2450, which is our center frequency. And you notice there is no substrate, but when I click on OK, we have to provide a substrate, and it tells us a substrate is needed. We can load from a library where we have a number of substrate manufacturers, libraries. There's GE, Rogers, Taconic, if you scroll through the different substrates. But I'm going to use a standard FR4 substrate for this design. And as you can see, I double-clicked on the FR4 substrate. It's recalculating, and it has now changed our ideal models into microstrip physical models. And if I zoom in on the schematic, you can see that we now have microstrip models with length and width for each of the parameters. Now I can also click on Create a Layout, and when I click on this, you'll see in the schematic a Layout tab comes up. And if I click on the Layout tab after it's completed, it will open up the layout, and it has generated a layout for our filter. The next step is to perform a MomentumGX EM analysis on the layout to verify that there are no parasitic coupling effects within the layout that could affect our filter response. As you can see here on the Options tab of MFilter, MFilter automatically prepares the layout for a momentum simulation. I can now close the MFilter properties, and I'm going to expand the layout. You can see that the input port and the output port were automatically placed. As shown at the top are the pads for the three capacitors that are in the design, and there are ports automatically associated with these capacitor pads that you don't manually have to place ports to perform the momentum simulation. If we double click on the layout and go to the layer tab, you can see that the stack up for our design from top metal, substrate, bottom metal, etc. is shown on this layer tab, and you can decide to mirror or plot these different layers, and you also set up what type of substrate you're going to use and whether there is a cover on your design. So I'm going to minimize again. I'm going to bring up our dockers by clicking on the button on the top so that we bring up the workspace tree again. And to add the momentum simulation, again we go back to the workspace tree and this new item button. I click on it, go to analysis, and go to add momentum GX analysis. From here we'll enter in our analysis frequencies. I'm going to duplicate what we simulated in the linear simulation, so that's going to be 20. I'm going to change this to megahertz, make it 2075 through 2825. You notice that we've selected adaptive frequency sweep, which chooses the number of points that it needs for the simulation. There's also a simulation options tab where you can choose RF or microwave mode and various other selections such as the via models, whether you want to use 3D metal or whether you want to use a box. The mesh is set to automatically mesh the layout. You can override this if you wish, but we're going to leave all of these other parameters as default. So now to start the simulation, all you have to do is click on the calculate button. You can see it's red, which indicates that we need to recalculate the design. Okay, we've completed our Momentum GX simulation. That actually took less than a minute on this design using Momentum GX. And if you look at the layout, you can see how the meshing, that Momentum, it provided extra edge meshing, and you can see that it uses both rectangular and triangular mesh around our via holes and any place that we might need additional meshing. So to look at our Momentum GX simulation, I can add it to our graph, linear graph. I'm going to expand that, double click on the graph, use our measurement wizard. I'm going to select our momentum data, which had stored our momentum data set when we did our simulation. And I'm going to select S21, and then I'm going to hide our S11 just to compare the two S21s. And as you can see, the the red is the linear simulation, and the green is the Momentum GX simulation. And there is some slight shift in center frequency and pass bands a little bit narrower, but it's a fairly close response that we have. After you've completed the Momentum GX EM simulation, you can transfer this new data to Spectrasys to verify that your system design parameters are still being met. When this is complete, you can then transfer the layout information via Gerber or DXF export to a prototype house or machine and create a prototype. This can then be imported back into Genesys via our TestLink interface and also again transferred back to your circuit design or your system design to verify your prototype parameters are still meeting your system level design. We didn't cover it, but the circuit design also includes transient harmonic balance and DC simulation that can also be performed. When all of your parameters and designs parameters are being met, you can then release to manufacturing. Alternatively, you can export the design to ADS and continue there if there are other simulations, such as circuit envelope simulation that can be performed in ADS. Thank you for your time. Please feel free to browse other Genesys videos on this website. For more information about Genesys products, please contact your local Agilent ESOF representative or select the More Information Related to This Video link on the same page.